The other thing we wanted to touch on, before we even go to, we want to talk about dynamic fees, but I just wanted to get your sense, Aaron. What do you think about the C chain, man? That's like your baby. How do you feel about it? Is it where you thought it would be?
I feel like exactly that way. I feel like it's my baby.
Like, how do you feel about it today? Are you blown away? Are you like, no, I knew we'd be at 500 dApps a year and a half in, or are we farther or less far? How do you feel?
To be honest, I didn't plan that far ahead. I didn't think of exactly what is it going to be. I really knew that we had a fantastic team. I knew that we had fantastic founders. I knew that the team around us, especially as we started to build out the BD team more, the DAP squad, I knew that we were building fantastic things on top of it. I knew we were building or bringing in great developers, building out our community in a huge way. And it's crazy to see the number of people that are building on it now. And it's not to say that I didn't anticipate it becoming big. I definitely anticipated it becoming one of the top chains out there. I knew the tech that we had. I knew the team that we had. And this is absolutely the expectation. But I never really thought about it. I never really thought about how much are people going to use this. I never really thought about how many developers are going to be on this or anything like that. And now to look at graphs like this, first of all, that just looks so beautiful. And second of all, to see how large the numbers are on them, it's pretty surreal. It's crazy to see. Yeah. Stuff like this. It's funny because whenever people ask me what I do, sometimes they'll say, oh, like, show me your code. And so I'll show them the code. Like, literally I'll pull up Corey and say, yeah, this is what I do. And then, you know, they don't know Golang. They don't know programming in general, and not that impressed. And then I pull up Snowtrace or stats out of Voxel Network, and they're like, what? And it's cool. I mean, I didn't build stats out of Voxel Network either, but it's cool to see all of these stats. It's really cool to see everything that's built on top of it now. It's pretty amazing just to be a part of that.
Oh, it's amazing. And now that we're seeing some of these dApps that are getting so big that they're going to spin off their own subnets and their own EVM subnets, it's even more exciting. Plus, there's just there's like this ecosystem, and then there's this, this isn't a fully formed thought, so I may stumble across this, but I've often thought of like software ecosystems, software platforms as like ecosystems, right? And then I've often thought of software code bases almost like like living organisms in the ecosystem, and the code is kind of like the DNA. And then whenever you see something forked, it's almost like, you know, whenever you have a branch on the tree of life and it splits into two separate species, and the more changes happen on each side, they can no longer breed, right? Effectively, that's the way it works in nature. And it's kind of similar in the software world if you zoom out far enough. And I think it's just very interesting to see what we're going to see in the Avalanche network because of this whole idea of subnets combined with this this open source kind of mentality where people can just take stuff and fork it and change it, where we really do have kind of like this living, breathing ecosystem. And we are going to witness this sort of survival of the fittest Darwinian type of thing, where the ideas that make sense are just going to thrive like our C chain. And the ones that don't, they aren't going to make sense, and they're not going to thrive. And, you know, their genes of this particular code base are not going to be passed on. So that's one of the reasons I just really love Avalanche, because I love these networks where you ultimately see these Darwinian sort of evolutionary themes play out over time. And I think we're going to see that if we look at our network in 5 years, 10 years, 100 years, it's going to be very clear where you're going to be able to trace back the lineage of some of these chains, which we can't even imagine now. It'll be, you know, fifth or sixth generation subnet EVMs, and you'll be able to trace back what worked and what didn't. Where did they split, and which branch died and which thrived? And it's one of the things I just really like about Avalanche, that it sort of acts like that. We have a platform, we have an ecosystem, and we're just going to see which ones work and which ones don't. So,